Just in, Obama issues nasty church shooting response, he went too far. Late Sunday morning, tragedy broke out when Devin Patrick Kelly opened fire at First Baptist Church in Sutherland Springs, Texas before the situation could be assessed and victims counted or identified. Democrats were quick to politicize the tragedy, including one former president. While bodies of the slain were still at the crime scene, Democrats were already using the tragedy to further their agendas. According to the Daily Caller, former President Barack Obama tweeted a brief message of condolence followed by another message calling for gun control. May God also grant all of us the wisdom to ask what concrete steps we can take to reduce the violence and weaponry in our midst. The message came just hours after the massacre happened. At approximately 11:30 a.m., Kelly was said to have carried out the worst mass shooting in Texas history. He was identified as Devin Patrick Kelly, 26, of New Braunfels, Texas. Kelly was said to have served in the Air Force between 2010 to 2014, but received a bad conduct discharge. He was court-martialed in 2012 for allegations of domestic violence. Officials have not reported any other misconduct or criminal history. Former President Obama wasn't the only Democrat that called for gun control in the immediate aftermath of the shooting. Within hours after news of the massacre broke, Senators Bob Casey, DPA, Dick Durbin, DEL, Kamala Harris, DCA, were sure to reiterate calls for gun control. Senator Casey tweeted, "I'm thinking of and praying for all those impacted by the shooting in Texas. In addition to offering my prayers and thoughts, I also believe Congress must take action on gun violence." Senator Durbin tweeted, "The shooter turned his gun on people, kids, in a place of worship. America is in the grips of a gun violence crisis. Congress must act." Senator Harris tweeted, "Senseless gun violence has torn apart another community, this time in a house of worship. When do we say enough is enough?" Senators Richard Blumenthal, DCT, Dianne Feinstein, DCA, Elizabeth Warren, DMA, Chris Murphy, DCT, and Representative Mike Thompson, DCA, were other members of Congress who echoed the gun control sentiments via Twitter before the body count could even be confirmed. It's unclear what gun control measures President Obama and others believe would have prevented the massacre. As far as available information shows, Kelly was not a felon, and did not have any other conditions disqualifying him from firearm purchase. He legally purchased his Ruger AR-15 from Academy Sports and Outdoors in April 2016. Furthermore, it is unclear whether or not Democrats' vision of gun control would have prevented a local resident from using his own gun to engage in fire with Kelly and chase him from the scene. Local resident, Stephen Williford, retrieved his own rifle and used it on Kelly, firing and striking him in the side between the tactical and ballistic gear that he wore. Kelly dropped his firearm and sped off in his vehicle. Afterward, Williford flagged down another resident, and the two pursued Kelly in a vehicle chase until Kelly's vehicle crashed 8 miles from the scene. It is unclear at this point whether or not Kelly killed himself, or succumbed from the wounds suffered by Williford's shooting. In any case, had Williford not used his gun to fire upon Kelly, the lives claimed by Kelly's deranged rampage could have been much higher.